Hi, I'm Will Patterson, and today I'm going to be showing you the necessities behind grids. I'm going to be showing you why you need grids and how you can actually use them inside of a vectornator. It's going to be a fun one, so make sure you watch to the end. So inside a vectornator, we have the options up here to select the grids. Down here, we can have the snap to, but we also have the artboard and grid options. We have a normal grid, as you can see, I can show it. When we zoom in, you'll see that the grid is actually here. It's very faint on the screen, but this will help you with a lot of your designs for layouts. But we also have something called isometric, which I've got a video up in the top right of the corner up here, which will show you how to design isometric lettering, which makes it look 3D. We're going to stick to the perpendicular grid, and we can change the spacing and everything right here. You'll see in this document, we've got this ruler on top. This allows us to equally space things and to create guides. And to create a guide, we simply just need to tap on here, and we can create a guide going straight down there. You can see that this guide means that we're starting the lettering and the layout from the left. We do the same on the right. To get rid of a guide, just hold that guide and just drag it up and it will get rid of it. But we can do this as much as we need to. We can actually create guide points down here for where things should be throughout the design. So for instance, here I know that clean hands can be slightly bigger if we needed to. I'm just going to increase that to where it just overlaps here. And we want it to overlap because this is a rounded shape. The S is rounded and it's called overshooting, which makes it look like it's in line. For this here, we want to make sure it's in line. And the same for be kind. We want to make sure it's just slightly above, like so. I want to make sure that this part here, which is the break in the poster design, is in line with some of the objects in the poster. And the best place to align it with is actually to bring it over here next to the E. So where the E ends is where this is going to end also. So get rid of all those guides and you'll see that it looks even better now that we've consistently matched everything up. Now, there's another way of creating guides, and this is creating guides from shapes. Now, what I've got here is actually my company logo, and I've brought it in. It's a vector. I've brought it in here, and I've changed the opacity so we can see the guides. What you'll see in your layer form over here is this little nub at the top right. Click that nub, and it will bring you to a new toolbar to the left and also this new layer panel. What we can do with logo design when we're sketching is use grids to make it easier and scalable. Guides allow us to have good scaling on our logos, and it also means that we're consistent throughout. So the way that the guides are created for this, I'm just going to show you. We're just going to bring out a circle, and you see the shape, it is an actual guide. It's been drawn out as a guide on a separate panel on the right. We know that we're on guides because it says guides up here. We're going to go ahead and copy and paste this circle and just bring it down. Now, obviously, I'm not reconstructing the original guides because we already did that for the sketch of this logo. But what I am doing is showing you how you can do it yourself. So say this was a sketch. We want to make sure things are in line. Well, the first thing I would do is I would look at the main components of the W. I'm going to go ahead and create a guide from this thickness here of the W. And what we're looking at is the thickness between how fat this stem is. I'm just going to bring this guide all the way out. So what we want to do is take this, copy and paste it, and move it across. Now, the reason why we do this is because we want to make sure that these two are the exact same thickness. This is how we get consistency. What we also want to do is make sure that the end is in the right point as well. And the next thing I'm going to do is create another line down here. I'm going to simply copy and paste it like so. Just drag it up. Make sure that this angle is exactly the same. Then I'm going to highlight both of these. Copy and paste these two. Then I'm going to bring out another line. And we're going to create one like this. And we can expand this afterwards so we can make it actually a bit bigger. The guide should normally overlap the shape so you can see where we're going with it. Again, we're going to copy and paste. It's really important to copy and paste them because we're trying to keep things perfect. Now, you see here, This is one of the examples. In our logo, what we would like to do is get this line to be the exact same angle as this one, but you can see that it's not. So this would be a time where you would change the design unless it has some sort of optical discrepancy. Now the next ones are circular lines. These are just gridded lines. To make sure that these are perfectly circular, what I've done is I've gone ahead and I've created a circle, and up here on this sort of weird serif that we created, I've made sure it's a perfect circle. Now you may think, how did I get this here? Well, again, that is actually another circle. So we go ahead and create a bigger circle and we're going to match it. And this could be quite difficult to do, but it makes the design easier overall. So we're going to match exactly, or as close to as possible, the curvature. After a bit of time, I've gone ahead and created the circle in the perfect shape here, but it doesn't work here. And that's because the line here isn't the same. If you remember, we need to change this line to make it the actual perfect logo. You may be thinking, what about this part down here? Well, it's the same thing actually again. We just use a circle, select it. We can actually put an anchor point there or a little placement to get the circle exactly right. And there, we've created the grid. So the main reason why logos should be gridded and your design work should be gridded is for one, consistency, and also to make it easier for yourself. It keeps everything nice and balanced. The main one for logo design is scalability. I know that this logo, ours, scales really well because geometric shapes also scale very well. So designing this logo with a bunch of geometric shapes, I know it's going to work. Hope you learned a lot about grids. I hope it was insightful and interesting as well. For more videos, make sure to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.